Whether it's record-breaking rain or a catastrophic hurricane, Florida homes need to be built to last. A new structural building system called RENCO is bringing the state's homes into the future. This new Lego-like housing complex can withstand a Category 5 hurricane.
That's amazing. You think about that. It's all thanks to this new material that can survive water damage and endure winds of over 150 miles per hour. 157 is Category 5 strength. It probably will stand up to that, too. They say the material is 23 times stronger than concrete and less expensive. On top of that, the Lego-like mold of the building blocks can speed up the construction.
So. Yeah, I looked at some of the video and I saw the picture. I said, yeah, this literally looks like Legos. You stack them up. We've got RENCO spokesperson Patrick Murphy joining us now. Can you tell us what this new material is made of that makes it so strong that it's rated to withstand a Cat 5?
Yes, well, sure. It's two things that really give it its strength. Number one is the materials that go into it. Recycled glass, recycled plastic, calcite, which is like a limestone dust, and then the resin. So it's a mesh that is in some ways like a fiberglass that is very strong. But beyond that, it's the fact that it's an entire building system, right? It's not just the walls and these Lego pieces that you're seeing. It's the trusses, it's the roof, it's the decking, and it's all glued together. The glue acts as a weld, similar to when you're working with steel. That weld is stronger than the material itself. Same for our material. So when we glue a joint together, it creates a chemical reaction and bond, and that's the strongest part of the block. So if you have a 2-, 3-, 4-story building built of our material, once you glue it, it becomes monolithic and very strong. And I heard there in the intro, you mentioned 157 miles per hour. Well, we passed testing upwards of 250 miles wow. per hour.
That's amazing. So, Patrick, I'm thinking it's kind of like a sausage of all the building materials in one thing. Is it expensive? And number one, it's expensive. Is it heavy? Is it easy to transport?
Great questions. Let me just really high level. There's basically three ways to build in the developed world: wood, metal, and concrete. Right? This is the fourth building system ever approved in the United States. Mm-hmm. So it's a big deal. On top of, you know, all the attributes I mentioned on the strength, it is significantly lighter. It's about an eighth the weight, which means your foundation doesn't need to be as deep and as heavy, mm-hmm. less rebar, et cetera, in it. It's all unskilled labor. As you see there, it's all Lego blocks. When we send the blocks out, it comes with color-coded plans. Oh my gosh. So any unskilled worker can assemble them, basically. The heaviest piece on this building there you're showing, that's a 96-unit apartment in Palm Beach, Florida. The heaviest piece is around 80 pounds. So you don't need a crane, right? So two guys or whatever can lift it up and put it right in place, glue it together. So it's really easy to work with. It's unskilled labor. It's very strong. And it's about 20% less expensive than traditional construction.
I think a lot of people, outside of all the other things we were just discussing, that's a big selling point right there, obviously,
so
the cheaper cost. But in Florida, just in recent memory, Michael,
right.
Idalia, mm-hmm. Irma, this year or last year, we had Ian and Nicole.
I mean, it can withstand this?
Yeah, as Florida effectively becomes more resilient.
The Category 5 state.
Right.
Exactly.
Are you thinking that this is really going to catch on across the Sunshine State?
We are. We're getting contacted by quite a few developers and quite a few potential owners that want to work with this, because one of the real problems we're facing in Florida, and quite frankly throughout the U.S. as we know, is rising insurance rates. And a lot of that's driven by these catastrophic storms and unexpected storms like we saw just yesterday in Florida. Mm-hmm. And the lifespan of this material is 250 years. To put that into perspective, wood is typically 25 years and concrete is typically 40 years, right? So we saved a ton of money on insuring this building because the lifespan is so much longer. The material doesn't rot, mold doesn't grow on it, termites don't eat it. It's extremely durable. There's no rebar in it, so there's not a spalling that you would see in concrete or other similar structures.
So that was my next question, was real quickly, cosmetically, can you paint the outside of it?
Yeah.
How does that look?
So the finished product looks like any other product. It can be workforce housing. You can stucco it. You could put a cladding on it. It could be a Four Seasons hotel if you wanted. Wow. You could put marble on it and, you know, paint it any color or brick or, you know, any sort of finish you wanted. So this is just the structure of the building.
My wife is sold, Patrick. I appreciate it.
Yeah, we were blown away by the tech. It is exciting. innovation. We wish you the best with it moving forward. Patrick Murphy with RENCO USA, thanks for joining us on Fox Weather.
Thank you.